Welcome back. I'm Wyatt Goolsbee, in for Lauren Ashburn. Pope Francis declares war on bullying.
El bullying es un fenómeno de autocompensación.
The Holy Father says bullying mostly is about being selfish and trying to tear people down to make yourself feel better. He says the remedy is not sold in a pharmacy. Instead, the cure is to be brave enough to take time to talk and listen to one another. Catholic artist Jacopo Tintoretto was one of the most prolific 16th century Venetian religious painters. Now, for the first time in North America, the National Gallery of Art is exhibiting some of his work. Lauren Ashburn explores the beauty of faith in the painting The Last Supper, featured in Tintoretto, Artist of Renaissance Venice.
Joining me now is Jem Sullivan, author of The Beauty of Faith. Hi, Jem. Welcome back.
Thank you, Lauren. It's great to be back, and thank you for having me.
Absolutely. Sunday is the Feast of the Body and Blood of Christ. It's fitting that we look at this painting called The Last Supper. Tell us why Jesus is illuminated in this. The light around him is very pronounced.
Tintoretto was a man of deep religious faith and a painter of extraordinary talent. His paintings are bold, he has muscular, large-scale figures, his brushwork is loose and fluid, and he captures movement in the most dramatic way.
Right, they're all leaning over the table here, and it seems that the apostles are very engaged.
That's right. What he does is he paints this scene of the Last Supper some 9 times, and this work is one of his greatest achievements. He gathers the figures in a triangular composition with Jesus at the head, and what Tintoretto wants to do is fix our gaze on Jesus, his calm, serene face, radiating light. Why? Because this is the moment when Jesus is giving his disciples and us his greatest gift, the gift of his body and blood, as he institutes the Eucharist.
I see a hovering figure here in the background. I'm guessing Judas.
Well, Tintoretto captures this dramatic moment at the Last Supper when Jesus tells his disciples that one of them is about to betray him. And so we know from the Gospel of John that it is Peter, the Apostle Peter, who reaches out to Jesus and says, Lord, tell us who is going to betray you. And then there is this figure of Judas lurking in the background to indicate his shadowy act of betrayal. That he's about to complete, that will lead Jesus to his suffering and his death on the cross for our salvation. So there's this wonderful sense of light and shadow to evoke that sense of the contrast between Jesus's act of love and this act of betrayal.
I was struck by the costumes, but the clothing. I've never seen Jesus in pink. It looks pink, and there's a blue, I guess, blanket around him. Tell us more about the dress that he chose.
There's marvelous details in this painting, of course. The pink is probably more of a reddish pink, and the blue. Always we see Jesus in red and blue, indicating his divinity and his humanity, clothed in the one divine person of the Son of God. There's also other wonderful details. The table, the wooden table, the simple meal, the rustic chairs, all of this to indicate this poverty, the simplicity of this moment that is really a rich spiritual feast.
And this can be seen in Washington, D.C. at the National Gallery of Art. Jem Sullivan, author of The Beauty of Faith, thank you so much for walking us through this amazing work of art.
Thank you, Lauren.